Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. Today we are going to discuss regarding anxiety disorders part 2. It is generalized anxiety disorder. Definition: generalized anxiety disorder is defined as excessive anxiety and worry about several events or activities for more days during at least a 6 month period. The worry is difficult to control and associated with somatic symptoms such as muscle tension, irritability, sleeping difficulties, and restlessness, etc. Epidemiology: the estimated ratio of women and men is 2:1. In hospital cases of anxiety disorders, around 25% of patients having generalized anxiety disorder. The onset in late adolescence or early adulthood, even though more common among older adults. Comorbidity: generalized anxiety disorder most often coexists with social phobia, panic disorder, or depressive disorder. It differs from panic disorder by the absence of spontaneous panic attacks. Etiology: the exact cause is unknown. Biological factors: effects of drugs such as flumazenil and beta-carbolines works on neurotransmitter system. Positron emission tomography shows that decreased metabolic rate in basal ganglia and white matter. Some genetic study shows that women are in risk to get generalized anxiety disorder. It is common among first-degree relatives, monozygotic twins than dizygotic twins. Psychosocial factors: cognitive behavioral therapy suggests that patient with GAD responds to incorrectly and inaccurately perceived dangers. And psychoanalytical thoughts suggest that anxiety is a symptom of unresolved and unconscious conflicts. The clinical features: sustained and excessive anxiety, worry accompanied by either motor tension or restlessness. The pattern must occur more days than at least 6 months. Motor tension include shakiness, restlessness, and headache. Other somatic symptoms like diarrhea, giddiness, palpitations, etc. Course and prognosis: it's difficult to predict. Some life events indicated with onset of generalized anxiety disorder. It may be well be lifelong. Treatment option under three heading. First one, psychotherapeutic approach. It includes cognitive behavioral therapy, mainly relaxation and biofeedback, and also insight-oriented training. The second one, pharmacotherapeutic approaches. It includes benzodiazepines, SSRIs, buspirone, and venlafaxine. And the third one is supportive approaches, includes supportive therapy. Thank you.